today we are going to be touring my mom's house. We did this over, what was it, fall, I believe, and you guys loved her house. So here we are at Christmas time. She decorates way better than I do, so you guys are going to love this. So we're gonna start at the Christmas tree here, which is beautiful. And she's just gonna go through and tell us where some of this stuff is from. And I will leave any links for you guys in the description box below.
So a lot of my ornaments on here are either shiny brights that are old or shiny brights that are new, which can now be found at a lot of the Home Goods. And some of these mercury glass looking ones are also from Target, so those can still be purchased. These like this, I've got some old vintage ones that my parents actually have gifted over the years in a collector series, and treasure those, and one day Britt will probably inherit all of these cute little Santas and candy canes and teddy bears and things like that. So these are vintage, but they are thin glass. Those are from Kirkland's.
Okay.
And there are several of those on here that are from Kirkland's, and I found them on sale. I think there's a few also of little stockings, and there are a few Hearth and Hand ornaments on here as well.
She also DIY'd her own garland. If you guys want to go and follow her on Instagram, we are going to be doing a giveaway. I will talk about that at the end of the video, but make sure you head on over and follow the both of us on Instagram. That way you can be entered into the giveaway. But as far as the garland goes, she did this herself, and she also made the tassels here. So maybe if you're lucky, you'll get a DIY on Instagram on how to do that. But I think it looks beautiful.
These are some old spindles that came out of a chair, and they were long spindles and they were cut in threes. And then we just added these tiny little hooks and put a little string on there and hung them from the tree. So these are all wood, but they are vintage spindles from an old chair. And yes, it was originally red. So this is just some, Britt was talking a little bit, touched a little bit about this garland, and this can be found at Michael's. It's a really thick yarn, if you will, in the yarn section, and I just braided it. So you can use it like it is, or you can braid it, and you'll get, out of one large roll, it covered my tree. $6.
It feels like a chenille or something. Is that what that is?
Really nice chenille yarn.
And then your topper, is that from Target?
Topper is from Target. Okay. Yes, last year, but they've got some similar ones this year. So I wanted to share with y'all, if you saw the fall tour, these flowers I used for fall, and the good thing about white or even a creamy color is that you can use these all year long, and just by taking out the oranges and maybe the mustards and just adding a little bit of greenery and red, you can change the total look of it for the season. I also moved a frame in here, and the frame kind of just acts as a backdrop for this hanging basket. And you could do this on a wall. You could do this like I did, just hanging it off a hook. And then I just added these candy canes that I had made several years ago.
And the basket is from Target, right?
Basket is
and
from
I've
Target.
Seen those there. Yes, right now.
They did bring those back.
So we'll link that below for you guys. That's also from Target. That's in the Hearth and Hand section. And then the sign is the Between You and Me signs, and then that is from Target?
That is from Kirkland's.
Okay. Last year?
Last year.
Okay. We'll see if I can find a similar one, but
they do have them
pretty,
at Target. Yeah. I think they look a lot like that.
Yep.
And this pillow, I believe I purchased at Home Goods last year, and this pillow I purchased at TJ Maxx this year. And the good thing also about decorating with neutrals, these are pillows that I already had. And I love to add a little bit of navy blue, which is my color year-round, and use that all through the seasons. But decorating with neutrals is you can change it one or two pillows and keep the rest all year long, and it goes with everything.
I like this one right here.
Yes, me too. It's one of my favorites, and that's a Home Goods. Y'all know I took Britt's mantle down, and we changed it a little bit and just moved it to a different wall, took the sides off, but I couldn't let this go without just throwing the wood away, so I decided I would bring it home, make something with it. So I just cut them down and attached the sides here, and then made a box, put a piece of wood on the bottom and made a box, and then just filled it with greens and candles, and these are from the Hearth and Hand line this year.
And this is old IKEA, but you could do this with any garland, any berries. These are from Michaels. These red ones are from Michaels that I bought this year, so they are still available. But this is great seasonal. You could put this on any table and you could change it out for the seasons just by adding greenery or plants when it's not a season, but very versatile.
These ornaments are actually old. A lot of these are old Shiny Bride ornaments. I have picked them up at vintage stores and mixing the old with the new. I think these are some newer Shiny Bride ornaments, but they all go together so well. The colors, you can do this with reds and greens, add a little silver. I suggest you picking three colors, gold, silver, and red, or gold, silver, and green, or whatever color works best for your taste, and just throwing those in an old wooden bowl. And mixing old and new, you all know that I love doing that. So the brass and the pewter color with greens and old books, anything like that can just really make a home feel and look cozy.
That's a, is that called a crock, right? Uh-huh.
This is an old crock, which I love, starting to kind of collect these a little bit. And this, y'all, don't be afraid to shop the Facebook Marketplace. I found this for $30 from a guy on Facebook Marketplace, which is a steal if you know anything about crocks. And then this is just one of the Hearth and Hand trees that I just sat down in there and then added some twinkle light.
And I shared a little bit about the sign that I made up here above this little makeshift mantel ledge. Kind of did a tutorial on that, y'all, but it was rough. So adding some old books, again with the tying a ribbon, adding a few candlesticks, and then this garland I picked up at another vintage shop, and just added in the red berries, which is always easy to do just by adding a little bit of color. So this jar, you probably noticed also in the fall tour, and I had it sitting on the table. I just moved it over here. This held a lot of the fall flowers, and I took all those out. And again, with this, I had these in for the fall, but left them for the white. And again, you can recreate this look just by adding the berries and the greens and switching that out, leaving the white, but these are good to use all year long.
So I threw this together on my island here for the kiddos. This is just a little cocoa bar, and using mainly everything that I had already. These old mason jars work great for cocoa, marshmallows, even your sprinkles if you want. I think I picked this up at Home Goods just to have it all contained in a little jar. But these are from Target. These are the sugar paper line. Great straws. You don't have to throw these away. They're washable, which plastic. I also love, and they're plastic. Yes. And then these little cute candy cane stripe spoons I found at Hobby Lobby, and I believe that you can still pick these up. These were honestly a dollar maybe for a 12 pack. And here's another little crock to add to my collection. And then I just set a little tree, and then these were picked up at a vintage show last year. And I also found these cute little old candy store tags, and they come out, make a little appearance every Christmas. You'll see a couple of them here and there. So you probably saw this scale over in the fall video that we did, and it was sitting up here. I just moved it over, and now it holds some Christmas candy for the kiddos, and let's be honest,
these are my favorite.
So setting a table, y'all, does not have to be complicated. And yes, you do have to move all this when it is Christmas time. This is only for show. So we don't all sit here and have all this stuff in the way, but white dishes, and I know y'all follow Britt and she talks about this, but yes, this is very important that you, white dishes can go a long way in switching out your decor for every single season. And just by maybe changing some napkins, adding an apple, anything red, you can even do an ornament. And then these are also ornaments, and a little bit of greenery tied with some ribbon goes a long way. This is an old, it's not old, I shouldn't say that, but it's old to me. This is from Pottery Barn, and I found it at the outlet many years ago. And it makes a great centerpiece for a table on an entryway. It's a great piece because you can change it for the seasons, add different things inside of it, and it just always looks really pretty and simple. This table runner is from JCPenney, and I bought this last year, but they may have brought it back this year, so you may check the store or online.
Okay.
And see if they've still got them.
They got a link.
But this little area, I made this sign, and I didn't really want to take it down. I actually tried to put the different sign there, but it didn't work out, so I just hung a wreath in front of it, and instead of always switching your decor, you can always just add a wreath and something red, and I think it makes just changes it up a little bit for the season. The banner is from the Target Dollar Spot last year, but I have seen cute ones this year, and you kind of get the idea that you can hang anything there. The Joy Towel is from the Hearth and Hand collection this year. And the Mary Pillow is also, you probably saw that in Brittany's house this year. And I picked that up at TJ Maxx.
Those bottle brush trees are the same ones I have from Hobby Lobby. And that looks like a Target tree.
That is a Target tree, sitting in an old red bucket.
It's a good idea.
I wanted to share a little bit about these. Now, we talked about the tassels that were on the tree, and I made these last year. These are just a yarn ball, and these make great fillers for wood bowls or even things like this. And this was an old ornament, and I just bought a spool of yarn, which is great because you can choose any colors that you want and wrap these balls in them. And then this year when I decided to do the tassels, I just unwrapped these, made the tassels, and then hung those from my tree. But I had a few left, so I just pop them inside these old containers with the tree. And it dresses up a little area.
You can use even like red if you wanted to do some red or all, you know, green or whatever. Cool.
So to some of you, this area may look a little different and new. This was a purchase that I just made. I picked this up at a local vintage store, and eventually we'll open it up and decorate the inside with the shelving and some old dishes. But for now, for Christmas, I love the way it looked. This little garland I picked up at Michael's. And it's the tiny, tiny little stockings, and they're so cute.
You got it this year?
Mm-hmm. I found it this year. It's really cute. And this is actually one garland. I just happened to cut it because it looked better the way, a little bit shorter pieces for me. So you don't have to cut it. It will go across a mantle or wherever you want to put it. Again, with the trees, I love all these little trees. These two are from Target, and this is from just a local vintage shop that I've had for a while now. The Santa mugs are all the rage right now, and these I picked up at Dirt Cheap when we did our haul, except for that little vintage one up there that I acquired at a little local shop. I love these old Santa mugs. They're hard to come by, but if you can find them, swipe them up.
Yeah, I'll leave the links below for you guys. I know that Target still has some. This was originally from Target, right? Last year. So they do have some. I haven't seen the smaller ones. I've only seen the bigger size mugs. And then World Market has some, and Pottery Barn has some.
Yes.
I think World Market and Target, they're the same price, but Pottery Barn's probably a little more expensive.
Actually, I saw an ad on Pottery Barn today showing they had them for $7. So go get
them.
Well,
all right.
We've gone with just the creams and the natural green, and then I've added some gold and a little bit of silver. But this is normally what my room looks like. I just added a few Christmas touches with the garland up here and on the mantle, and that was picked up at a local shop, so I don't have a link to that, but you can recreate that with any of the green garland. Magnolia has some nice green garland out right now for about $20. Really cute. So you can recreate that look very easy. And just by adding a pillow on your bed or a pillow in a chair changes the look for the season really easy. And then there's not a lot to store at the end of the season. I know a lot of you have seen the picture on Instagram. So I changed up the mantle just a little bit, leaving all the mirrors that I had in the fall, and just added some garland, some stockings, and then just using again the old gold and silver candlesticks that I already had. So this whole look did not cost me a penny. I had everything already that I've kept over the years. These are the little Dollar Tree these are the Target Dollar Spot houses, and I just propped those up there and added some ornaments in here with some old books. These are also the little tassels that y'all saw me, I showed you on the tree that I made. I made them for stockings also. And then just used some white ribbon to just kind of fancy it up a little bit.
And then where's this tree from?
So this tree I found at a local vintage shop, so it's not something I can link. And then these were all from Pottery Barn. It's Spell Out Snow. I bought those several years ago for really cheap and just held on to them, hoping that they're very fragile, so hoping they don't break. This is also from a local vintage shop, and I'm just hanging that to change out for the seasons. It's also cute. You could hang pictures there, signs, whatever it is you want. It just kind of adds a little bit of whimsy to your room. This is the Opal House.
This year
tree. You can find this, I know, at Target online, and it does have a very vintage feel to it. I mm-hmm. love that about it. And I don't think they're, I want to say they're $20-$25 right now, but.
Okay, and we made it into the kiddos' room here, and I try to not overdo it, but I love to decorate for the little ones and just kind of make it a little magical here. But this tree I picked up at IKEA this year.
All the ornaments I've had and kind of collected over the years. I think there's a few Target ornaments in here, but they're just very kid themed. This is from Home Goods. This is just the garland that I've waved around, and this did take two. So if you can pick those up, they're very fun. I think TJ Maxx sells them also in all the fun colors. Now these stockings are, I think these are from TJ Maxx, and these are the Hearth and Hand line, I believe from about 3 years ago. This was one of their very first stockings when they first came out. And then I just hung these old little ornaments here for the other two here.
Where are those from?
These were from Home Goods also. And I think they came in a pack of two or three. So you can probably still find these if you can go look in the store.
And this is Target Opal House last year?
Correct.
Yeah.
Yep. These, I probably showed you this. There was a few pictures of these, and I just took these little trees from IKEA and drilled a hole down in these, and then just made these into little bottle brush tree stands, if you will. This I wanted to share kind of with y'all. These old, getting a frame and taking them. I had this old Christmas, a night before Christmas book that someone gave me many years ago, and I took old pictures out and I put them in these frames like this, and this is part of the Christmas story. But framing things like this is a great way to just add a little bit of nostalgia, and you can also do it with gift bags. So this garland is from Target, and I did pick this up last year, but I love this garland, especially in the traditional colors, because you can use it every year. I just weaved it in and out with some old toys and some old toffee tins. So during the year when you're looking around and you're out looking for vintage things, always think about Christmas. I keep that in mind. You can put anything in them during the year, even a regular plant, but then at Christmas, you bring them out, and it adds so much character and whimsy to a space. So this pillow is from Home Goods last year, as well as the one behind it. It kind of has a little bit of a Swedish Christmas feel, but I picked both of those up last year. And another way to add a little bit of fun to a kid's room is just by buying cute little Christmas pillowcases. Adding that into a room for a child is also just magical, and it's a super inexpensive way to change the look of a bed for a season. So dressing up a little corner or a little space that's kind of forgotten is really easy to do by taking a chair. This is an old tin that I had. You could even set a large tree if you don't have Crocs. You could take an old tree and set it down in there, and then dress the space up just by adding a little bit of pillow. And again, with the little Hearth and Hand, the old trees from Target. They're not Hearth and Hand.
They're a Threshold.
But Threshold brand, yes. And then a little greenery with just a pop of red. That's all it takes, y'all, some old books. It just dresses up a little corner of any space. Don't forget, you know, that you can use these all year round, but just buying a colored ribbon that will dress up the space and adding that to any wreath, you can hang those anywhere, and just by changing the look. And all of my stuff is being hung with command hooks, as you can see up there. I haven't put any holes in the wall. It'll be easy to take those down and change them out.
So that wraps up the Christmas home decor tour at my mom's house. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to check out my mom's Instagram as well as mine. Follow us both and enter the Target gift card giveaway on Instagram. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to my channel if you are new. And I will see you guys all in my next vlog. Bye.